Game cameras are an incredibly useful tool for monitoring wildlife. Although they've been around since the 1980s, recent advances in technology have made them much more affordable and easy to use. There are literally hundreds of different models out on the market. You can pay anywhere from $80 to $800 and up. It all depends on the amount of features that you want to get, but the only indispensable feature that you need is an infrared flash. The infrared flash allows you to take photographs of nocturnal predators at night and other wildlife without being detected. Another good rule of thumb is that it's always better to have more game cameras out on your property rather than fewer. So if you have the option to purchase one high-end model or several less expensive models, it's always better to go for the less expensive brand. That's because even an inexpensive game camera will give you good enough photographs to where you can identify most wildlife species on your property. Before you head out into the field, you'll want to make sure that you have fresh batteries in your camera. You'll also want to make sure that you have an empty SD card. Typically, if we're going to leave the camera out for 5 days to a week, we use a 4 gig card that will allow you to take up to 4,000 photographs, roughly. You also want to make sure that you set your time and date so that the photos will carry a date stamp. And then you'll want to experiment with your particular camera to find the settings that work the best for you. But on these little Bushnells, I typically do 10-second intervals between photographs, and then I set it to take 3 photographs in a burst. Also, I set the sensitivity to normal. One of the best places to put a game camera on your property is along your roads. That's because predators use roads typically to travel from one area to another. It's convenient and easy. So if you want to catch them as they're moving about, it's best to mount a camera on a pole such as this. You can even you can make a T-post work. But what you want to do is put your camera at about 2 feet off the ground or so, and mount it securely to the pole, just like that. Sometimes these straps are a little flimsy, so you'll want to make sure that you secure it. And orient the camera at a 45-degree angle to the road so that you have a wider view of predators moving up and down the road. Another thing that you want to be aware of is the vegetation that you have in front of your camera. Even a small blade of grass moving in front of this camera will trigger the motion sensor and fill up your card with images. So you want to pick a spot like this that has bare ground with virtually no vegetation in the way. Or you want to take a weed whacker out and weed whip all the vegetation down to bare ground. There are a couple other good places to photograph predators or other wildlife on your property. One of those is watering holes or riparian areas, and also any wildlife feeders such as deer feeders that you may have on your property.
Even when you're not using your game cameras for monitoring the various carnivores for the quail index, you've made an investment in these. Get the most out of them. You can use these things 365 days out of the year. Today's models are pretty efficient with their battery. You stick a 4 gig memory card in there, you don't have to come back and check it all that often. I like to monitor especially two places. One are my water holes. When it's 105 degrees out there, everything wants a drink of water. We monitor the water holes here, the road runners, for whatever reason, are one of our most common visitors to these water holes. Another place I like to monitor is if we've got a well-traveled road from a varmint standpoint and it pinches down through a gate or something like that. That's a great place. Leave that camera up a lot of the time so they get used to it. Many of the critters, especially coyotes, are what we call neophobic. They have a fear of new things. So leave that camera up most of the time. They get used to it. Really don't pay much attention. You can get some incredible photographs, you can get some incredible video. You'll enjoy camera trapping all the more. Another great place to put your trail camera is on a well-traveled road, somewhere where you know is a varmint highway. Like this one, I've got taped pretty low. I'll get a good photo. I'm scanning that area out there. We've got some really nice photos here of bobcats, one even carrying a quail in its mouth, and coyotes and that kind of thing. So again, another great way to employ this technology, which is very user-friendly these days. You'll get some incredible photographs and you'll enjoy camera trapping.